Tia, as the producer and all-around executor of this documentary, what are your objectives for the audience?
I think that it's really important to see the journey that each person takes from beginning to end of the program. Also, it's important to see the journey that not only the individual takes, but that we take as a group, so how much closer we become, and the different things that we learn about one another.
I think Lens is fog.
Hi, my name is Ethan Chapman. I am a outgoing, artistic individual who's always open to new things.
My name's Darius Tignanelli, and I am a returning.
I'm Abigail Duquette. I go to St. Joseph's Scholar Hall. I'm involved in the S.O.L.E. program here. Some things that I really enjoy doing is horseback riding. I have to say my favorite fruit is definitely cantaloupe.
Hi, I'm Noah. I'm a pretty positive and happy person, and I like to have a lot of fun.
I'm Mackenzie James Calarco, and I love the outdoors, I love music, I love technology. I'm English, I'm half Italian. I don't know what else to say.
Hi, I'm Jasmine Forshew.
Hi, I'm Jake Ibbotson, and I'm an outdoorsy kind of guy. I like fishing.
Hi, I'm Fraser Armstrong. I'm really girly and I like rainbows.
Hi, I'm Shana Bentley, and I'm pretty outgoing and just excited.
Hello, I'm Matt Caculo, and I just like to have fun and be active.
I'm Edward, and some of my traits are I am smart, intelligent, I'm a quick thinker, I'm good in the outdoors, I've been outside since I was about 6, good at making quick fixes if we ever run into issues, and I'm very industrious.
Hi, I'm Tristan Metcalf, and I like cats.
I'm Melissa, and I really enjoy my job.
Hi, I'm Scott Graham, and I enjoy my photography for the class and the athletic and outdoors.
Hi, I'm Taylor. I'm First Nations person going here at St. Joseph's College.
I'm Zach. I'm athletic. I like sports, enjoy games.
I feel like there's more knowledge that I could apply to my life in this class, from learning in this class, than I would just learning out of a textbook.
So I first heard about S.O.L.E. last year. The idea of it was introduced to me, it was still in the making, and I thought it was amazing because it's not the same as your regular bell routine, your regular classes. It's really interactive, and it's really more like it's an environment where everyone is collaboratively working together, but you grow as an individual.
I signed up for S.O.L.E. just for the different learning opportunities that it offers and the different way it looks at learning and how people learn.
I signed up for S.O.L.E. to explore the outdoors and find where I want to go.
Something beautiful to touch me. I know that I'm here to reach, because I am down on my knees and waiting for something.
What strengths do you bring to the program?
I think I could be a good leader in the right situation, and just a nice guy.
I don't really have a lot of strengths, but just trying to be positive about it and help anybody out who has trouble with something that I understand.
I bring technological. That's about it. I'm pretty strong.
I don't know it all, so I'm excited to learn new things about
them. I think I bring my openness to the program and how accepting I am of people's abilities and people's disabilities.
I think I'm a positive leader. I like to win, whether we're doing competitions and stuff, but I can still know how to handle myself, and I'm fairly athletic, I'd like to say, and I can help with whatever tasks are needed, camping and stuff.
If I can carry things, I have no idea. I don't know.
You're in a position of leadership right now, so you will be blindfolding your partner, and you will be guiding them around the room. And certainly you can make up things like move to the left, right, because they've placed some chairs in there. Move to the right, duck. I don't mind, but what I'm asking you to do is you have to come up with a persona where I would like your voices to be too low. I need you to just move to the left, can you? Where there's a certain degree of frustration, or you can be loud and not nice. No swearing, of course, but.
So do we alternate between?
Yeah, move left, take a right. Okay, like, and so try and be something other than yourself that way. And there's just a lesson in this. Okay, so, and so your instructions don't always have to be clear. Now please play the role. And it'll last a few
minutes.
I think
it would help me more or less relax and just kind of breathe through everything so that I know, and I'm able to put myself in a state of mind where I'm able to further go into my life and think about my future.
Really looking forward to learning more about myself.
I just want to see what kind of leader I am working with new people and seeing if I have better patience, and just see, like, just be the best person I can be.
I think it'll help me realize who I am and where I should be.
Share how you genuinely feel about about being led. So,
how
would you describe this leadership?
Very
bad.
He was very unspecific, and I'd do what he says, and he'd get mad at me for doing what he said. Not good.
Not good. No. How about here?
More specific.
But
it was just, it got kind of quiet, everybody else was yelling. And it
got
really quiet. And then I was just really kind of confused. Like, what am I doing? And then I ran into someone.
Who am I running to? I ran into someone. What am I doing? How's it going? It's pretty easy because most of the first ones are not like playing.
Okay.
No, the other one left, I'm afraid.
Did you feel he was in proximity of you,
yeah,
or far away?
It's kind of talking quietly, and so it's a little far. It was
a little harder. Okay. So not too cheap.
At one point, I think I was really close to the wall. I just felt like it was really cold.
Okay. Now over here.
With simple instructions, got all quiet at times. Though I don't like since he's quiet, I feel like he's far away. But I think just because I'm not
okay. Okay.
Yeah, it's just pretty simple. I don't know, just good instructions. Except for the yelling, it kind of was hard to hear, but yeah. Other than that, it was good.
Okay.
I had pretty basic instructions. It was pretty good. She was kind of quiet, though. I couldn't really hear.
Okay. And here?
It was pretty easy. Just going where you go, only went there.
So it's not so bad?
No.
In terms of feelings of trust, and you felt secure and safe. This is I felt the most insecure. This is I felt the least secure. That's how it works. Yeah. So let's see. This is your fingers.
So
let
your fingers be close to the
inside.
So we're done.
Yeah.
Trust.
This is
half.
Okay.
You're not the sideways the whole time.
Well, yeah.
postcard. Words take a long way home. Risking all where the world began, yeah. Say, can you hear the sound of the great unknown?
Say, can you hear?
Oh, say, can you hear the sound of the great unknown? Say, can you hear the sound of the great unknown? Yeah, oh, 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 uh-huh. Oh, oh.
Early in the morning, I'll come calling, I'll come calling after you.
This is the definition of fun.
I actually don't even care that I don't have this color,
all in colors, children silent as the stars. Early in the morning, in the morning.
Two, three, go. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right.
Everything you want is ours.
Got him in the beard, that's not fair.
Oh. Victory!
Okay, like, do I have to stay in contact with the same person?
No, you can move over to, you can move over.
Okay. What are we doing? This is never going to work. This is ridiculous.
We trust it will.
We picked the hardest note.
There once was a man named Tony. He was nothing like Joseph Kony. He taught us to tie rope. He taught us to tie rope, not use a scope. Tony ain't no phony.
Man known Tony, his mind enlightened and fast. His hair was light and flowy. His motto, adventure, no turning back.
Yeah!
Oh,
oh,
my God,
that's
an actual whistle.
That's a whistle?
Is that a whistle?
Yeah, he's not using his lips though.
Yeah, that's the story. Prince, in a second.
Warm.
Delicate and grasses, white and ashen, green and sweet, a ruby nest.
So I'm like gathering wood. I just tested it and when it makes that sound, it means it's really dry. I actually really like gathering wood. It's kind of like knitting. You have to like pay attention to all the little details.
And how are you feeling emotionally about where
really,
you are?
Like, I'm giddy, but at the same time, I'm kind of like at peace, you know?
So at the moment, we're building a really awesome, no, we're not building a fire, we're getting ready for a fire, and we're cutting different sizes of woods so we can start the fire and then keep it going. And my mom's here, who's doing a fantastic job. She's doing the brute work of it, so.
Do you like it here?
I love it here, you guys.
She's the only reason we brought her along. That's the only reason, so.
Okay, jump on that, baby.
I have to jump? Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Oh, in the morning, with and singing, we will rise. Early in the morning, in the morning.
it's whistling your tune. That wind blew pyramids to Egypt and footprints to the moon. And that old star that you've been wishing on is shining mighty bright. But it's the fire inside your heart that's gonna lead you into the light. How you ever gonna know what it's like to live there?
How you ever gonna know
victory?
How you ever gonna know
what it's like when dreams become reality?
How you ever
a lesson from its learned. I guess love would not be love without a risk of being burned. Anything in life worth having, Lord, it has its sacrifice. But the gift that you're receiving is worth more than the price.
How you ever gonna know
what it's like to live there?
How you ever gonna know
what you never know?
How you ever gonna know
if you're down here doing what the good Lord put you here to do?
How you ever gonna know
if you could have done it?
How you ever gonna know
how it feels to fly?
How you ever gonna know
if you never dared to try? Listen on to the critics who put their own.
Hey Zach, how you doing?
Good.
Yeah? What's your favorite part of tripping so far?
Probably the canoeing.
Yeah?
Definitely enjoy that, yeah.
What about portaging?
That's pretty fun. Hard work though.
Yeah? Are you excited for dinner?
Absolutely. I'm pretty hungry to be honest.
Do you think you'll sleep well?
Oh, definitely. That's a for sure.
How you ever gonna know what it's like to be there?
How you ever
Mink Lake. It's a tiny little lake here in Algonquin Park. We just finished paddling through Kiosk and finished a great portage. 17 students, really most people their first time doing a backcountry canoe trip in their lives, and they're doing an absolute incredible job. Everyone's making an effort to get along and to learn, and I think this is what the outdoor classroom is all about, and it's really an honor and a pleasure to be with everyone here today and for the next few days as we learn and share together in the outdoor classroom.
What do you think is the most rewarding part of this experience?
It's twofold, I think, for me personally. Is seeing growth and development, and I'm just starting to begin to see that in the students, and I think that's certainly the most fulfilling for me. We're all the outdoors is a great equalizer. We're all here experiencing the same thing and working through maybe various emotions. But we're trying to get somewhere and do something together as a team. And to me, that's has a lot to be said about what we're doing on this trip, but in life. that it's great to work on things continually.
When we get back to the classroom in 2.5 days, I guess more than that, after the weekend, will things be the same?
No, I think this is a game changer. I think the best thing about canoe tripping is it changes people inside, touches it. I mean, hearing the birds and the sound of an upcoming, you know, Babbling Creek and kingfishers flying by and blue herons. And when we talk about how important it is to be connected to Earth, and this is the way it works, this gives us a better understanding and a much, I think, much more organic way of looking at...
I can't promise you that I won't let you down. And I can't promise you that I will be the only one around when your hope falls down. But we're young, open flowers in the windy fields of this war-torn world. And lo, this city breathes the plague of loving things more than the creators.
Where? You didn't get one?
I don't need this, but...
It's good for you, Freeze. Okay, so I would like everyone please to orientate the map to the direction of travel.
Well, that's north.
What if I was wrong? What if I was wrong? Oh, what if I was wrong? But hold on to what you believe. In the light, when the darkness has robbed you of all your sight. And oh, hold on to what you believe.
Silver Peak S.O.L.E class. Made it up in a faster time than I thought. It took 2.5 hours to get to the top, second highest peak in Ontario, and literally we're in the clouds. We just have a break here. Oh, we got some more clouds rolling in, and it's just absolutely spectacular.
Experience. We reached summit across the lake from this one, and we could see the peak from where we stood, and it was just an amazing moment of wow in a lot of pain in a few hours when we were on top of that. And now we're on the top. On the way up, we there were some pretty slippery rock faces that I didn't think we'd be able to get up. Did splits a couple times, but my boots held up. I'm gonna go home and gold cast them because they were just little troopers. And we faced some challenges and we had some nice scenery on the way up, and now we're on the top and our scenery's kind of gone and our challenges are gone, but it's nice, and it was totally worth the 3 hours.
Start from the bottom, now we're here. It's chilling at the top, you know, it's a pretty epic journey coming up. It's real tiring, but you knew it'd be worth it once you got to the top, and it was, so it motivated me to keep going. You know?
Can you describe the weather up here?
It is really weird because you're in the cloud and then you go and you head behind a rock and you're basking in UV rays from the sun because you're so close. So cloud cover. And cloud, and it was the most amazing experience ever.
It's almost like you're lying on a rock.
It's almost like I'm lying on a rock. But I am. It's really comfy. We can breathe nicely, so we're not that high up. Abby over here, she's a trooper. She got all the way to the top.
It was very difficult. It was a life-changing experience.
But she did it. Now you gotta go back down.
Can you compare the weather from at the bottom to the top?
Okay, so we were at the bottom. It was warmer, but not as windy. You get up here and the wind changes.
Ask maybe more like questions. A 15 degree temperature difference.
I would say 15 degree. And compared to here to up there, the temperature changes by like a lot.
How long did it take?
How long did it take? 2.5 hours.
Okay. And what do you think it's going to be like going down?
Going down, I think it'll be a lot easier, but it'll be more dangerous because
you need more skill.
Coming up, you could slip on so many rocks.
I think S.O.L.E. is really a really good program for someone who needs to find themselves.
This program is like no other, and every other school should see it as an example for them to try something like it.
In the spring, one sunny day, good gal left me, oh Lord, she went away. She's gone home, but I don't worry, no, I'm sitting on top of the world. She called me up, down in El Paso, come home, daddy, oh Lord, I need you so. She's gone home, but I don't worry, no, I'm just, I'm sitting on top of the world.
On top of the world, on top of the world.
Mississippi River, deep and wide, woman I'm loving, oh, she's on the other side. She's gone, but I don't worry, no, just, I'm sitting on top of the world.
On top of the world.
Don't like my beaches, don't you shake my trees, get out of my orchard.
Last trip, I think it'll just bring up everyone's true, gifts and talents and everyone's true potential. The two previous trips, I think, are just like the warm up, and this is it.
Oh no, I'm not cutting on it.
Is that what
that? Oh, hot sand on toes, cold sand in sleeping bags. I come to know that memories were the best things you ever had. The summer shorn
beat down on bone and back, so far from home where the ocean stood. Down dust and pine and bone. We slept like dogs down by the fireside. Awoke to the fog, we're all around us. The boom of summertime.
Hey Noah.
Yeah.
Can you tell me what the difference is with this campsite as opposed to the campsites we've had on our last two trips?
That's
a tough question.
Yeah, well, for this one we've got everybody camping at the same campsite. So it's like three times more crowded and there's not as much stuff to do. Well, there is. And I know. The tarp's a lot bigger. Thanks, Steck. Am I bleeding?
Yeah, yeah, you're bleeding. Yeah, you're bleeding.
This one, we've got different water system types.
No, but if
we have chemically treated
water. Oh, that's why you're playing with needles?
Yeah. Not my first time.
That wasn't even sarcastic.
So we're doing that. And we didn't choose the meal plan, so we're just kind of like finding out what he has. And we didn't bring any of our stuff, so this is all Leaders of the Day stuff.
And do you think there are benefits to having the knowledge of somebody else's systems?
Yeah, definitely, because it helps a lot knowing different techniques and what to do. Different styles.
We stood steady as the stars in the woods, so happy hearted in the warm.
Hi Jasmine. Can you tell me a bit about the group dynamics of having everybody here at the one site?
I think one of the more noticeable things about having everyone all at one site is, first of all, you have all the leaders at one site, so often we feel kind of a parental camaraderie with Mr. Dubray since we spend so much time with him, so sometimes we end up without him on trip and it just feels very strange. So I think part of it, having everyone at the same site, is sort of a familiar feeling, and it's cool because we haven't got to do that until this trip, which is our last trip. And so some people are cooking, some people are guiding the fire, some people are making wood carvings, and it's a very relaxed family atmosphere.
Right now, I'm not sure if we can tell on video, but it's raining.
It is raining.
Does the weather even faze you by this third trip?
I think if any of my gear got wet, it would really, really, really faze me in a bad way. But for now, since we're all set and we can be somewhere dry and warm, it's you're able to enjoy the scenery. It really speaks for... There's something swimming over there. You can't see it, though. Okay. it really speaks for preparation and knowing what you're doing and being prepared for things such as rain. So for now, it's fine and dandy, but on the fifth day when I'm thoroughly soaked, I'm sure I'll be a little cranky.
And how do you feel about this being your last SOL trip?
It's a little bittersweet. It's nice that we get to wrap things up and be finished with our certifications, but at the same time we are preparing to go our separate ways, and I'm sure by the fifth day it'll be more bitter than sweet, but for now we're just going to have fun and remember that this is SOL and this is what we do.
So at the moment we're heating up some pre-made chili that Tony was nice enough to make for us. We're making sure that the pot's like centered over this flame, and we're stirring it constantly so the chili doesn't burn.
I didn't touch it.
No one likes burnt chili.
Chili's not a good thing.
And Tamara, you are back with us. I am supervising. No. How do you feel about that? Oh, I love being with you guys. You were fun, awesome.
I don't know what else to say.
Do you see a big difference in our ability to work as a group since your last trip? Oh, huge, huge. You guys are amazing. I found you worked in individual silos. You know, you all did your own thing, and now you're working towards a common goal, which is really awesome.
Thank you.
Okay, Matt, can you tell me in what ways we've grown as a group since the beginning of the semester?
Well, we're definitely a lot more patient with each other.
we get stuff done a heck of a lot quicker. There's not as much bickering and arguing. We know the right way to do it. And we play to people's strength now, because now that we've been together for so long, we know what's what.
And for this campsite, we have, instead of having three separate campsites, we have everyone together. How does this type of campsite show that we've grown?
Oh, there's been no arguing. Like, we got this set up pretty quickly, and we're out of the rain, and I don't know, just, it's kind of cool. Less work for you, that's definitely.
And one last question. How do you feel about this being your last soul trip?
It's a little sad, for sure. I'm going to miss everybody in the class, and I don't know. I'm really happy I got the opportunity to be in soul. That's basically it.
Just to bless them all. Sat on toes, coats hanging, sleeping bags. I come to know the friends around you are all you'll always have. Smoke in my lungs, or the echoed stone. Careless and young, free as the birds that fly. With weightless souls.
What would you guys say is the hardest part of solo paddling?
Adversity.
Very good. And how did it feel to accomplish that task?
Felt great. So great.
We stood steady as the stars in the woods. So happy hearted in the warmth rang true inside these bones. We stood steady as the stars in the woods. So happy hearted in the warmth rang true inside these bones. As the old pine fell, we sang. Just to bless the morning.
Group of kids out solo paddling. Can you tell me what that was like?
It was really interesting, and it was difficult as well. It was really windy, and we were in the Back Bay, which is about as sheltered as we could get around here. And unfortunately, when you start, it's nicer when it's calmer, but it's very windy, and people got pushed back. Sometimes when it's really windy, anywhere at any time, it can wreak havoc on our psyches. So sometimes when we've got the mental part to deal with as well, it's a bit. But overall, I think the students worked out really well once they worked through that and listened to the instruction and were able to, even windy times, be able to get those units down and to show them competent, demonstrate them competent that I felt good enough to be able to move on to one or two other strokes and to actually have a come to conclusion. So on the whole, to the rest of our students who accomplished it, I'm proud of them, and I would hope they would be as well.
What would you say is harder about solo paddling, the mental part or the physical part?
I think it's the mental part, because you're using the same basic strokes, but you're actually doing them lighter with less power, it's much more finesse. You're also having to deal with wind conditions, and also you have no one else to rely on but yourself. And in a way, there's a lot of life lessons for solo paddling, and sometimes if you can conquer the things, or maybe not conquer, but maybe be more at peace with the things that we're working on to improve them, sometimes it makes things a lot easier.
And in terms of a more general topic, what do you think is the biggest difference between you sort of running our trip and having leaders of the day run our trip?
I don't know if I could come up with a big one, because it's really interesting that we see things very see things through their eyes, and that really helps. Also, we try and allow for a formation where we're empowering students to be able to make collective decisions, take leadership roles, and to try and see things through and work on a team. Because again, it's not the first person through, it's the last person that really shows the accomplishments of what it is that we're doing.
And last question. How do you feel about this being your last trip of this semester?
Ooh. I don't know. Lots of emotion there. Everything. Happy, sad, mostly grateful. A lot of gratitude. First year of the program as well. And to think that people are walking out of here being certified to be out with new people is such a huge accomplishment. To see the beautiful things that took place in the classroom and to go from not knowing each other to become, I think, a very beautiful, dysfunctional family. And I say that, with lots of good intentions, that we can work with each other and do things well, and that's amazing.
Thank you. So, Shanna, can you tell me what's been different on this trip in comparison to the other trips?
Well, Tony brought all of his leaders of the day stuff, so he has all our meals planned out and, like, where we're going and staying and stuff.
How do you feel about this being your last SOL trip?
Kind of sad. I love tripping with everyone.
And what do you feel is the most important thing that you've learned on our SOL trips?
How to work with people.
I got SOL, but I'm not a soldier. I got SOL, but I'm not a soldier. I got SOL, but I'm not a soldier. I got SOL, but I'm not a soldier.
Opportunity. He sees everything you ever wanted. One moment. Did you capture?
Hey, recording. What do you have to say about this? Get your head out of my belly. How do you like the trip so far?
Well, it's almost over. Uh-oh. It's, I don't have my interview voice on.
Oh.
Neither do you.
Alright, so I'm Tia, and you haven't seen me very much because I'm usually behind the camera. Behind the camera now is my current assistant, Ethan Chapman, and it's my turn to be on the hotspot.
Okay, so Tia, talk about what has been your greatest fulfillment in the SOL experience?
I think that I've really taken a different outlook on life in general through SOL. Our first trip, I felt this really strange sense of contentment that continued on afterwards. And it's given me a more positive outlook on life, I'd say. And it's kind of just this idea of when a problem comes to you, you deal with it, you get through it. You don't sit back and watch it happen. You take it by the reins and you just continue going on.
There's a bunch. Definitely getting a silver peak with the whole group has to be.
I'd have to say the most fulfilling thing about SOL is just being able to work with different people and learning all aspects of everyone's personality. I mean, there's such a dynamic group of people here that not knowing about everyone and not working together is...
Your time.
I don't know. One of my best experiences was being able to stand on Silver Peak.
Yeah, that was definitely a feat for all of us.
Darius, you got the Heart of S.O.L.E. Award at the Academic Awards a couple weeks ago. What would you say the Heart of S.O.L.E. is?
Well, in my opinion, the Heart of S.O.L.E. is more than just an award. It's more of the bond that we share as a class and what we've all gathered together.
Hi, Thayla. Last night, you received the award that deals with outstanding outreach for the community within S.O.L.E. Can you tell us a bit about your journey with the community during this semester?
Well, this semester, I've been working with the grade 8 students at Mother St. Bride's as part of the junior ASL program, and I've been working with them and helping them with their self-esteem and going through the program with them. I've also been working with a lot of people for the powwow that I've had to postpone, but I ended up getting a lot of contacts and going out into the community to work with them. I've also gotten a chance to work with my fellow peers.
So Matt, you got the Outstanding Leadership Award for S.O.L.E. last night. Can you tell us a bit about your leadership style?
I don't know, I just try to include everybody in what I do and what I think is best and try to make sure everyone's included.
How would you say our classroom has been different from a sports team, if it's different at all?
I don't really think it's different. We have one common goal and it's just trying to reach that goal. It's just like a sports, try to win. We just try to complete the task as a group.
Would you say that your approach to leadership has been different because of S.O.L.E.?
Oh, it's definitely improved my leadership for sure. I've been more open to other people and more patient, and it's helped me in sports even.
Patience is a good thing to have.
Yes.
Last night you won an award at an awards ceremony. Can you tell us a little bit about it and what you worked at to achieve it?
The award that I received was overall academic achievement for our class, which means I have a slightly higher academic average than the next person below me. Apparently it was a close running, which I think is fantastic. There was a lot of hard work that went into that. It's not about doing the work, it's about putting yourself into the work. If you enjoy what you're doing and if you put your heart into what you're doing, because you're not just reading some really long article written by Henry David Thoreau 100 years ago. You're reading something that's relevant to your life right now. So if you really put yourself into the work that you're doing, it makes a big difference.
We'll do it all.
Like, I don't remember ever being this close with a classroom of people in my entire life, and that says a lot considering how people act in elementary school. Bring bug spray. It's really important. It might not help you. Don't sleep on hills. And don't take advantage of the opportunity.
You know, we can all have a conversation. It doesn't matter who we are outside of S.O.L.E.
What do you think has been the most fulfilling experience for you?
Probably when we got to the top of the mountain. That was pretty awesome. Just when we saw the clouds open up after being up there for a while and then view.
What would you say to students who are taking S.O.L.E. next year?
Don't give up, just have fun and complete every portage. Don't be that person to take a break and say, I can't do it. Don't be that person.
You mentioned to me that you didn't really feel you were part of the family that we all felt we were a part of.
Yeah.
Can you tell me if that has changed, and if so, how?
Yeah, it has. I feel like my opinion matters now because people listen when I speak, and I'm not just kind of like following people around and bumbling through activities. I'm actually independently thinking and giving my opinion, and people are listening to that opinion and using it as part of their like game plan.
Would you say that you've grown as a leader throughout this course?
Yeah, I think I'm not afraid to make decisions now. I'm not afraid to execute them myself.
What would you say has been your most fulfilling experience within S.O.L.E.?
Definitely Silver Peak, actually. I know a lot of people are probably saying this, but climbing that mountain was probably the hardest physical thing I've ever had to do in my entire existence. And as soon as I got to the top, I'm like, woohoo, I did it, and I'm quite halfway.
And what would you say to students who are taking S.O.L.E. next year?
Be patient. the program just keeps on getting better and better, even if it's kind of slow at the beginning, there's a lot of book work, but just, and whatever you're doing, do it to the fullest that you can do it. Don't slack off just because you're not interested in it. Whatever we do in the program, it always has a purpose to build up to what we're going to do in the end.
How do you feel about this being your last few days of S.O.L.E.?
Well, it's definitely sad. The hardest part was probably the fourth night on a canoe trip, just knowing that it would be our last time on a canoe trip with our instructors and just with everyone we met.
Don't be like me, dear. Stuff in time.
Take good bug spread.
Bring toilet paper on the camping trip, too.
Consider yourself lucky. It's a great course, like once in a lifetime opportunity, and just seize the moment.
I would tell them just give it your all. You only get out what you put in. So
these people are my life. Like I spend 6 or 7 hours a day with these people, and this is what we're doing. This is what we get to do together.
Yeah, that's pretty circular.
Yeah.
Yeah, little shoulders. And then it's like a hat. Like you're sitting on the toilet. That's what's going on.
Leaving will be the hardest part about leaving. Because we're such a small group, we've actually become literally a family, and it's just going to be so hard to separate from everyone next year and know that while S.O.L.E. has led us to where we're going, it's going to be very hard to go our separate ways at the end of the year.
Thank you.
So an incredible year is coming to an end, and it's a really magical group of people have come together. And to think from our first day together to our last day, the growth is immeasurable. And it's not just in the students, I think that growth is inside of me as well. Every person in this class has left their mark on me in such positive ways. To think that we've gone through this entire semester together, and we've done it so beautifully. We have always focused on the last person through, not the first, and to me, that's magic. That's when there's a true understanding of how a group functions together and how we can accomplish certain tasks and goals. We've had such similar experiences, and yet we perceive them and look at them so very differently, and how we perceive and look at them is so important, and that really is the beauty of our class, is really in our differences. But through those differences, the neat part is where the true commonalities come through. Everyone has been really good with each other, and it's sad in so many ways to say goodbye, but to me, there's really no goodbye, and really there's just another fantastic beginning, which is just about to happen again. A new chapter for all of us as we move along in life. And I trust there will be a little more pep to a step, and maybe a new way at looking at how we go about our lives, and to do so in a positive way. So really, this is a thank you.
2, 1.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me.
Working together.
Mac and cheese.
$100 for the real deal.
Probably the best meal.
Part of solo paddling.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands.